Oh, you're so much taller than me.
You gave me the bad stroll.
I gave you the tall chair.
It's the bad stroll, but I am taller.
Well, you know, you are a bit taller.
And I have nowhere to put my feet because I am actually taller in person.
Oh my goodness. Well, I could take the other stool, but it's not the right, it's not as comfy as this one.
That's my point.
Okay.
You're a bad dad.
I am a bad dad, but let's get to it. All right, Sam.
Alrighty then.
So, Sammy's going to join me for some videos. We'll see how this goes. A topic unknown to her.
I have no idea what we're doing at all. I got my wine, though, so, you know, cheers.
Let's figure it out. If we want to, you've done sound, you've toured Warped Tour, you've got enough of a knowledge of it.
Some knowledge.
Yeah. And we've got a wide array of microphones that we have selections of. I'm going to grab some.
He's really just pulling from, let me tell you guys, a literal pile of microphones. Just all sitting on top of each other.
In a big mess.
Yeah. I don't know if he's going to grab all from the pile.
No, I'm just going to grab the pretty ones and some odd ones and some ugly ones. So we're looking
like
at some mics.
Seven, so, eight, ten so, more.
Yeah, so here's a AKG D12. If you hit that on your hand gently.
Jumpy.
Cool. Yeah. It's got a springboard in there. And these are popular. They started off as a vocal mic, and then later on they became a kick drum mic. This is a Sennheiser 431. It's kind of neat. Pretty, right? It's got the little dots around it, but it's not the most gorgeous. What's really interesting on this mic is you can unscrew these screws. This plastic thing comes off and it's a smooth mic, and this is an on-off switch that works through a magnet that passes through the shell.
So once you take the screws off, it's not an on-off mic.
Yeah,
a lot of people don't like it.
It's a choice of an on-off, and it's, they were popular mics for a little while. No, never that popular. here's a Sennheiser.
This is a cool looking mic.
4-4, yeah, it's beautiful. One of the most beautiful mics to work on, too, to open this up, the way they open, I'll do a video on it someday.
There's
a screw that comes out, and this little thing slides open, and there's this gorgeous shock mount. This is another one that you can gently hit and feel the shock mount in there. We'll go on to, I don't even know, what is it, 416, I think this is?
This is kind of a funky one. It looks like the Space Needle.
Right? It's just a little, it looks like a ball, like almost like a diamond ball held in a Yeah, this one always reminds me, the 441, it looks like a shaver, kind of an electric shaver.
This looks like a miniature version of the mic we just saw.
It's made by the same company. Yeah, it's definitely related, this Sennheiser 416. This is kind of an odd mic. I don't see many of these around.
And that has a spring loaded in it, too.
Here's another one. That's, I think, a 413. So these are all, I'm really getting at here is just this really wide variety of and they're like gems. And the question is, why do we have all these microphones? And are they striving for, I mean, with speakers, they keep pushing to be striving for perfect sound, right? You're trying to get the best sounding one, or these speakers sound better. Everybody makes a claim to fame that they're at the most accurate. My question is, if we want to capture the most accurate sound that an instrument creates, why wouldn't we just use the measurement mic that we use to test the system as an analyzer? The analyzer mic is the most
accurate.
It's the most accurate mic we have in our toolbox.
Yeah.
It's a little condenser. It's basically what we use to design the speakers.
Yeah.
If it's so darn accurate, why don't we mic everything with it?
Why don't we?
I don't know.
What are the mics bringing to the table? What is this?
Well, and the interesting aspect is that the mics are, it's
no one wants to use it because it looks kind of funky.
Yeah, it's not pretty enough. it's not that they're, any of these mics are accurate. In fact, they're the opposite accurate. We're looking for the way they alter the sound, the way they ruin the sound, the way they, not ruin it, but they make it different. So they take the original instrument. So of all those mics we looked at, is there any of, which would you use to mic a kick drum?
Well, okay. Listen, I already know I have the insider knowledge on this. Okay. You also already said earlier that the AKG was the one that used to be vocals. You wouldn't typically mic a vocal with the same thing you would mic a kick drum. And I know that that is, the outside is a lie because you want the big dense mic to mic the kick drum. That's not a big dense mic. It's a little condenser, or it's a, I don't know if that one's a condenser, but it's a small particular one. I know that you want me to choose this one. Do you want me to choose this one?
I do want you to choose this one, but not for that reason.
Okay.
Typically, when you're micing a big thing, someone grabs a big
mic. The big one, yeah, I know. And I know that this one has the outer shell to look like a big mic.
Oh, it's big inside, too.
Oh, it is a big inside?
Yeah, this one is big. Yeah, but this, but you got the right idea.
He's trying to trap me. I knew he was going to try and trap me.
So let's go ahead and look at, so be using a big, heavy mic to mic a big, heavy thing, if the mic is truly big and heavy all the way through,
it's not
then
gonna
the diaphragm's going to be big and heavy. So you got this big drum that goes, and you get a diaphragm that goes, and so now it just goes, it just turns to mud.
Yeah.
So if you have something big and heavy, using a small, delicate mic to really capture its big and heaviness. Now, if you have something that's real shrill, like a trumpet, if you use a tiny little shrill mic,
it's just going to be a nightmare.
So you want to use the big heavy mic to mic the tiny thing and the tiny mic to mic the big thing if we're truly using mics to augment what an instrument's missing. Okay, so let's go ahead. I think I've got a way of showing this stuff. So what we'll do, video's going to get kind of long, so we'll take a break.
Sounds good.
Want some wine?
Cheers.
Cheers. All right.
Not for him, just for me.
We'll come back or do another one with some tests where we'll look at the difference between all these mics and actually see what they look like on a scope and what they're doing to the sound a bit. And then maybe we'll do a third version where we listen to those same things.
Are we going
to
look at the analyzer mic at all?
Yeah, sure.
Because I think that would be good, because if maybe we should be using the analyzer mic for everything. Probably not, but maybe.
That's true. We could try it.
All right. Let's look at it.
All right, taking a break. It's getting hot in here, too.
Yeah, it's getting hot.
Okay.